Just about set to kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. It's time for the coin toss now, presented by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Sure. Tees up the ball as we get ready for the opening kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's tackled at the 25. The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. Stays in bounds and made a nice catch.
I like how the blitz was identified and then picked up. That's a good test for a quarterback. How does he react in the face of pressure?
Brought down after a nice run up the middle. From their own 46-yard line. Second down. And he's tackled after positive yardage. Nice run there by the tailback, and it's good for the first.
If you can consistently get 4 or 5 yards at a pop, you know that you're going to have a functioning offense.
Paul, off the left side. And he carries the ball for a nice gain.
That's a gain of 6 on the play. That'll make it 2nd and 4.
He's taken down around the 44-yard line. Quick pass, and they make the stop at about the 41. It looks like he's a little bit short of the first.
Well, the quarterback should have known better than to throw that pass. At least give the receiver time to get past the first down line before you throw it.
He's at the 30. He makes his way to about the 28.
That makes it 1st and 10.
We've got a 1st and 10. Ball on the 28. Here he goes. He's knocked out of bounds at the 15-yard line. What a play.
Just a simple option play here. The quarterback gives it up, and they get good yardage. Great play.
The middle for a nice game. Looks like he flinched down there on the line.
False start, offense.
It's so tough to move the ball forward. Even a 5-yard setback can do damage to a drive.
2nd down and 9 to go. Ball on the 14-yard line.
So the Aggies saw one of their key guys go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to get back in the action.
Big play, and it's 1st and goal. Quick strike to the receiver, touchdown. Be able to find the end zone on that score, Kirk.
Well, you know what, Brad? This is great execution here by the offense. The quarterback seems to be getting into a little bit of a rhythm now.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. So an 11-play, 80-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. Fires out to his wideout.
Out of bounds.
Around the 28-yard line.
That'll make it second and seven.
From their own 28-yard line, it's second down.
Looks for his running back, incomplete. And there wasn't anyone in the vicinity.
I think the ball just slipped down on him.
Third down.
No good.
Nothing clicking there. Let's see if they can make a few adjustments before their next series.
Hayes is back awaiting the punt. They'll bring him down at the 35. And offense is back on the field after running the ball very well on their last drive.
This offensive line really opened up some big gaps for the running back last time.
Looking for his man, incomplete. From their own 35-yard line, it's second down. Utah State up 7 points. Catches it, and he's looking for more. At the 30, to the 20. Touchdown, Utah State. So they call a tight end's number, and he comes through with the score.
He did a great job here of using his size to create space for himself so the quarterback could get the ball into him without any defenders getting in the way.
He makes the PAT. A short two-play, 65-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 20. Oh, man, he took him down hard.
It's not quite a blowout, but unless they do something here, it might turn into one.
Caught, and he's hit immediately.
Davis hit the tackle at the 22-yard line. That makes it second and 10.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on their own 22. He's tackled
around the 30-yard line.
Gain of 8 yards. That'll make it third and one.
He makes it to the 32-yard line.
Called a gain of 2 yards. First down.
From their own 32-yard line. First down. Gives it up the gut. And he dives forward. A nice job by the offensive line, and they pick up a gain of 8.
That makes it second and 2.
The 40.
Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws it.
And here's another third down. They'll spread the field with 5 wide.
Fires incomplete. Was the intended receiver on that pass. So that'll make it fourth down.
Yeah, they just couldn't connect on a pass there. That was a very good stand by this defense.
Booming kick. He dropped it. He gets out to about the 22-yard line.
Kirk, he broke the cardinal rule there. He ran without the football.
You know, as a return man, your first responsibility is to catch the ball and then worry about the return. He just lost his concentration there.
The main thing is they got the ball back, and now they can go to work on offense.
The quarterback is on his way back onto the field, and he led a great drive last time out.
He airs it out. And he snags that one. Inside the 30. He's taken down at the 10. Nice play.
Good job here by the quarterback is staying with his receiver. And the receiver stays with the route because he knows his quarterback has the arm strength to get it there.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
But you can really mess with an offense's game plan if you can take away their ability to run.
From the 9-yard line, third down.
Robinson is the intended receiver on the play. That'll bring up fourth and nine.
The kick is up, and he's got it. They line up to kick this one away. From his own goal line, he's to the 20. Looking for the corner, brought down at the 29-yard line. Utah State's looking awfully impressive right now in defense, but we are in the first quarter.
Yeah, this is about as dominant a first quarter that we have seen in a long time. But let's see if they can continue to play this well throughout the rest of the ballgame.
Their last drive ended in a punch, so this quarterback's going to be looking for something better on this drive.
They've been beaten soundly on both sides of the ball, and we haven't even gotten to the second quarter. Alert read on that play. He didn't have too much time to react to that pass.
From their own 29-yard line, second down. And that's his receiver who's wide open. He's tackled around the 40-yard line. Right around the 46-yard line. So at the end of one quarter, the Aggies lead 17-0. And we're back for more action here in quarter number two. Now he tries to buy some time. And he's going to be sacked.
Boy, this pass rush is sometimes scary. They're really getting after the quarterback now.
From their own 45-yard line, third down. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Looks left, picked off. He's at the 40, inside the 30. The 10, touchdown, huge play.
How about the play by the defender? That was a great interception and an even better effort to bring the ball back for a touchdown.
And he tacks on the extra point. Utah State gets set to kick this one away. He sends this one deep. He's to the 20. He's taken down at the 27.
Well, this defense has got to be proud of what they've been able to do in this football game so far. Love to see the goose eggs up there for this defense. And the way their offense is playing, this game is really shaping together for this team.
So the offense will come back out onto the field, hoping for a little better result than that last pick six.
This quarterback needs to be a little bit more careful because this defense...
It's intercepted. Throws it to the outside.
Find out what kind of character this football team has. I mean, I thought they had a chance to get back into this game. Now this big interception, let's find out what kind of fight and character they have to try to get back in the game.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 39-yard line. Quick throw. They'll bring him down right around the 36-yard line. He didn't have much of a chance on that play.
Boy, this defense has a lot of speed. They're all over him by the time he caught the ball.
Tackle made at the 28-yard line. Gains his way to the 19-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 9 yards. That brings up second and one.
They'll go ground. He fights forward to about the 16. Taken down at the 6-yard line.
That'll make it second and inches.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle. And this play is number 8 on the drive. Touchdown, Aggies. This one has gotten out of hand.
Usually we don't see games get real ugly until the second half, when the talent of the depth chart starts to show. But man, we're still here in the first half, and it's already looking like a blowout.
And he converts the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He's to the 20. It's still only the second quarter. We've got a lot of football left, but I've got to say, this one is teetering on the brink of a blowout. Caught out in the open. And they make the stop around the 39-yard line.
Well, that's a big gain there for the offense. And all that's doing is giving this quarterback more and more confidence.
It's first and 10. Ball on their own 39. Quick strike and he drops it.
Number one was the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
Throw in left. Another catch. What a tackle. That was going to be a touchdown.
That's a very nice, relaxed delivery right there. Even in the face of the blitz, he held his ground and made a perfect toss. That's a big boost.
And the big pickup through the air has made it first and 10. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play.
That's got to be very frustrating for that running back. This offense is trying to get in sync and trying to get a rhythm established. And for such a negative play to happen, loss of yards, that can really have a negative impact on the offense and what they're trying to do.
Strike to his receiver. No good.
This wide receiver is very frustrated. You can tell by his body language. He did everything he needed to do to get open to be able to make a big play. The quarterback just didn't put the ball in the money.
It's third and 13. Ball on the 22-yard line. And he's level at the 29.
Loss of 7 yards on the play. That makes it fourth and long.
Kick is away. It's long enough. And it's good. Stein is lined up to kick this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down to the end zone for a touchback.
So the Aggies have put up 24 unanswered points. One team can't do anything wrong. The other team can't do anything right.
Things are on the verge of getting out of hand before we even hit the half. These next few drives are going to go a long way in determining what kind of game this will end up being. Utah State looking to add to this big lead here. Nice run, and he's brought down. 4 yards there on the old quarterback keeper.
That makes it second and six.
He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. Screen pass. He's got his halfback. And he tackles him hard at the 40.
That's a gain of 11 in the play. That makes it first and 10.
Makes it out to about the 50. Drill at the 46-yard line.
That makes it second and 14.
They come up to the line here. It's second down and 14 after the sack. Runs right for a nice gain.
That's a gain of 4 on the play. That brings up 3rd and 10.
If you kill it, motion me out.
Setting up blockers, the running back's got it on the screen. And he's tackled around the 46-yard line.
That brings up 4th and 7.
Utah State up big right now in this one. This one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. I'm really surprised how lopsided this first half has been. But this is college football, and no matter what the score is, the adrenaline's always pumping on both sides. They bring their quarterback down.
That'll make it second and long.
Defense looking for another sack in this second down and long situation. They come out in a 5-wide set. He's going left.
Hey, I know he dropped it, but the safety put himself in a position to make a play. That's impressive.
They line up at the 12. Third down. Gains his way to the 20-yard line. They'll head to the locker room in a game that's not even close. Utah State leads 31-3.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. It's David Pollack here in the studio, as always, to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. This game looks like blowout city. I don't think I'm crazy, David Pollack. I don't think it's taken up residence in blowout city. I think it's just passing through and visiting. We might have a comeback in store in the second half.
Well, I think you're crazy and you need to go to the halfway house and visit and stay for a while, because this game isn't going anywhere back the other direction. It's over. Put the women and children to bed. Go find something else a little bit more entertaining. Open a bag of chips. You know, start another season of something else, because this one's a wrap.
There's going to be a comeback.
So you're saying there's a chance.
That'll do it here in the studio at halftime. We'll try to see if Pollack can bring a little energy in the second half. Got a lot of games to watch, including yours. Brad and Kirk, ready for the second half.
Davis and Pollack, you should be here instead of Herbstreit and myself. Second half just about ready to begin. Lawrence fields it at the 2. And he's taken down at the 28. Not a whole lot's been working for them so far. They should just come out and play loose and easy, because they've got nothing to lose. There's a strike complete, and down he goes, around the 36-yard line.
That brings up second and one.
Short yardage situation here. It's second down and one. Out of bounds at about the 39-yard line.
First down.
He hits him hard at the 43.
Evans brings him down at the 43-yard line. That makes it second and six.
From their own 43-yard line, it's second down. Throws out to the running back, no good.
Chapman was the intended receiver on the play. That'll bring up third and six.
A great tackle at the 49. He made the catch, but he didn't get the first down.
Yeah, right now, the way this defense is swarming, there's just no room for him to get upfield for the first down.
Hayes is back awaiting the punt. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. It's going to be interesting to see how the action shakes out in this series. Utah State with a big advantage. Quick pass. He's taken down right around the 28-yard line. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. And they'll get him in the backfield.
But you can really mess with an offense's game plan if you can take away their ability to run. There's a reason why defenses hate playing against teams that run the option well. It's so unpredictable. That time they couldn't defend it properly, and they gave up a first down.
From their own 40-yard line, first down. Up the middle for a nice game.
That's a gain of 7 on the play. That'll bring up second.
So the Aggies running back taken out earlier, sidelined with that injury. However, it looks like he's going to be able to come back in this game.
Pitch is back.
Tackle after a decent pickup.
First and 10. Ball on the 49-yard line. And he makes it out to about the 47-yard line.
That's a gain of 2 on the play. That'll make it 2nd and 7.
Hey, defense, let's go. Pick it up, please. Check 59. Mike is 59. Mike is 59. Ready!
He gets out to about the 45-yard line.
Gain of 2 on the play. Third down.
Third down, and they need to get it down to the 39. Utah State is winning big. Fires quick after the receiver, and he can't make the grab.
Robinson, the intended receiver on the play. That'll make it 4th and 6.
They're trying to pin them deep with a solid punt right here.
He was able to deaden that kick perfectly. And he gives them a long field to work with.
I hope they show some fight here and try to stay competitive. If you're going to get blown out, you at least want to go down swinging. Tackle after a decent run up the gut. Chapman gets about 4 yards on the play.
That makes it 2nd and 6.
Second down. Tough spot here, deep in their own territory. For extra yardage.
That's a gain of 3 on the play. That makes it 3rd and 3.
Slings it, and they push him out around the 28-yard line.
First down.
From their own 28-yard line, it's first down. And they get nice yardage on that run.
Tackle. That's good for a gain of 4 yards. That makes it 2nd and 6.
He's wrapped up for the sack.
Less than 12 yards on the play. That'll bring up 3rd and long.
Well, they've converted 1 third-down play on this drive, but now they're faced with a 3rd and long. The Zips quarterback down there on the sideline, and Kirk, you and I talked to him earlier this week, and he is really the main cog in this offense. Doesn't look like he's that much pain right now. They need him back on the field before this one's over. Tackle around the 30-yard line.
Number 35 makes the tackle at the 30-yard line. That makes it 1st and 10.
Now it's 1st and 10 after the big pass play. Looks over the middle, and it's picked off.
Number 45 with the interception.
Brad, I'm all for continuing to fight, continuing to try to compete. But another interception, another miscue for this team, they're already getting blown out. They've got no chance to get back in the game.
From their own 39-yard line, first down. Utah State comes to the line holding that commanding lead. Here he goes.
He's knocked out of bounds around the 41-yard line.
That one's on the offensive line. They've got to do a better job of holding their blocks, or else this quarterback's going to be pulling turf out of his face mask all game.
They find themselves in a hole here after that sack at second and long. We head to the fourth quarter, and this one might be over. 31-3, Aggies. Not sure there's any hope for a comeback here in the fourth quarter, but Kirk and I are praying. Swings it out left to the halfback, and he's taken down at the 42. A lot of concern from his teammates with a guy down on the field. Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 31. Back's got it on the quick throw. He's at the 30, knocked out of bounds at the 25. First down. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 25. Utah State looking to build on this commanding lead here. He's tackled at about the 11. Throws complete, touchdown. Nice catch by the receiver for the touchdown.
Anytime you're near the red zone, you got to keep an eye for this guy. They love going to him down here.
You know, if a quarterback has a strong arm, one of his favorite routes is the post. But I thought the quarterback did a really good job here of using his eyes to move the safety, to open up that void in the defense, and then he made the good throw to the receiver for the touchdown.
And he adds the extra point. Thompson has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Utah State's just not going to let him come for air, I guess.
Well, this defense has just been stifling. They've shut down the running game. They've, for the most part, limited the big plays in the pass game. They've got a nice lead here in the fourth quarter.
Offense comes back out, looking to improve from their last effort.
This quarterback can make good passes. He just needs to focus on not forcing the ball to his receivers.
Under heavy pressure.
It's a bad play overall by the offense. The quarterback's doing everything he can to be able to make the play work and try to execute. The problem is the offensive line did not do a good job protecting him. They're very fortunate that ball wasn't intercepted.
Quick throw out to the receiver. They'll bring him down right around the 30.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That'll make it third and five.
From their own 30-yard line, third down. Just throws this one away. Ball to punt. He really got a hold of that one. What a collision! So the Aggies have been about as impressive as you can be in a football game.
This is as good as it gets. The defense is playing great. The offense has done their job. We've got a blowout here.
Both teams are playing out the stretch here. You want to get experience for guys who normally don't get in the game and try to avoid injuries. Utah State up big. And he's tackled after positive yardage.
That makes it second and six.
From their own 41-yard line, second down. Has some daylight. He's at the 40. And they make the stop at the 27. Let's see now how the defense responds to giving up the gain on the run. And he just gets rid of it. He was tackled immediately, taking back a yard.
Not much going on there. Those kind of plays will not work against this defense. You can be sure of that.
From the 28-yard line, third down. Over the middle to his tailback. He breaks a second tackle. They'll drop him for a loss.
Loss of three on the play. That'll make it fourth and 14.
Fourth down. So the kicker comes out. He'll try to put 3 points on the board. They're already up big, and this could make the lead bigger. Kick is up. It's got the distance. He clanks it off the upright. No good. I don't expect any once-in-a-lifetime rallies here, but that being said, we could still see some exciting plays. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Strike to his receiver. No good. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 31. And he carries the ball for a nice gain.
That's a gain of four on the play. That'll bring up third and six.
Across the middle, and he's tackled at the 43-yard line.
First down.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 43-yard line. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers. Fired quickly, and he's got his man, and he's leveled at the 48.
Evans with the tackle at the 48-yard line. That brings up second and five.
Gains his way to the 43-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
From the 43-yard line, first down. And he can't get away from the pressure.
That's a loss of 8 yards. That'll make it second and long.
So the sack makes this a second and long. Well, as they take a look at that injury on the sideline, let's see what this backup can do at quarterback. And he tackles him hard at the 37-yard line. And this play is number 8 on the drive.
Hold this.
Under a minute left. Well, a nice stop there late in the fourth quarter, but this game, quite frankly, has been over for a long time, and I'm ready for it to end.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
He fields a punt at the 20, and he makes it out to about the 31-yard line. We're late in the fourth quarter. This game has been a blowout for quite some time, and Kirk and I are just looking to make our flights. Nice run there. Hall gains about 4 yards on the play.
That makes it second and 6.
From their own 35-yard line, it's second down. Made right around the 36-yard line. And this one's all but wrapped up with the final score, 38-3, Aggies.
Akron, 3.
So that wraps things up for us, 3A Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.